Hello children, I hope you all are well. Today we are going to start political science first chapter, government. First you have to know about the government. What is government? Government is the political machinery, organization and agency of the state which exercises political authority, be making, implementing and enforcing laws, decisions and policies on all the people and their groups and associations living within the territory of the state. Now, the different categories of the government. If you follow the chart, you can understand about the modern government. Modern government is divided into two parts, that is unitary and federal. They are both in mixed form. Unitary and federal both are divided into two parts, parliamentary and presidential. They are also in mixed form. Now you have to know what is unitary state. According to DESI, a unitary government involves the habitual exercise of supreme legislative authority by one central power. So children, on the basis of this definition, we define a unitary government as the one in which all powers are in the hands of single central government, which will create the delegates some of its powers to the local government. Now you come back to the different stages of unitary government. You can see the point one, central government. In unitary state, all the powers are vested with one single central government whose authority is supreme over all the parts and people of the state. Second point is central government. That is, in unitary system, that under central government, the local government are create and vested with powers by the central government. These work as administrative unit or department of the central government. Come to the constitution. Both central and local government, both are ruled by the constitution, and this constitution is written or unwritten. Since there is no division of powers and all the powers belongs to the central government, there is no special need for a written constitution. The constitution can be written or unwritten in accordance with the wishes of the people. This constitution, again, it can be flexible. The central government alone has the power to amend the constitution, and in this sense the constitution of unitary state is always flexible. It has the administrative units of the central government. The existence of an all power of central government exercising total power over all the people and the place leads to a single, stable and strong administration. So this is about the unitary government. Now we are coming to federal state. Federal state is, according to the Hamilton, defines federation as an association of states that forms a new one. Another politician, Montesquieu, said, "Federal government is a convention or agreement by which several similar and smaller states agree to become the member of a large one." Now, here you can see the chart, and from this chart you can understand some features of the federation or federal forms of the government. Point one, the division of power. Division of powers between the central government on the one hand and the state government is on the other hand. There are different ways in which the division of powers between central and states stand affected by different federal constitution. For as example, the US constitution specifies the powers of the federal government and gives all the powers to the state government. Come to the written constitution. Constitution always, here you can see the written constitution. Since in a federal constitution, there has to be effected a division of powers. It become essential to do so in writing in order to make the definite and binding upon both the central and the federating state. Such as a written constitution is a must for a federation. Come to the third point, that is rigid constitution. A federal constitution has to be a written and rigid constitution because it is to be kept from unilateral amendments on the part of central or state. Only the central government and the state government together can have the power to amend the constitution. Come to point four, that is independent and powerful judiciary. In a federation, the judiciary performs the role of protecting the supremacy of the constitution. This is done by exercise the power of judicial review over the law of the central and state government. It is also called a dual administration. A federation is characterized by dual administration. Point one, uniform administration of central government for all the people of the federation. Point two, the state administration which are run by the government of federating units and which differ from state to state or region to region. It is also called dual citizenship. In a federation, each individual gets dual citizenship, one common uniform citizenship of the whole state and the second of the province or the state of which he is the resident. In the United States, each individual enjoy both the citizenship of the United States as well as of the state of which he is a native or resident. Now, it is also bicameral federal legislature. In a federation, the legislature of the federal government is make a bicameral legislature. In one house, the people of the federation are given representation, while in the second house, the units of federations are given representation on the basis of equality. In the United States, the people of the country have been given representation of the House of Representatives and the 50 states of the USA Federation have been given equal residence or representations in the Senate. Now, it is also a federating state. It is called one of the key principles of federation. It is equality of the federating unit. All states and units of the federations are equal without any consideration of size, population, and resources. It is because of the requirement that all states are given equal seats in one of the two houses of central legislature. Each number state enjoys equal rights and autonomy. This much today about your federating state, and I hope you all will understand about the government. Thank you very much.